My name's Rich Harrington.
And I'm Jeff Greenberg.
And a lot of times in the editorial workflow, you're going to find that the shot you put in just doesn't work, and you're going to want to find a replacement.
Or your client comes in and goes, I love that shot, but I think we shot some other stuff. Can I see some alternatives?
Oh, yeah. I love producer's memory, which basically says, well, I'm absolutely certain there's a better take.
Always.
So you're going to want to quickly find that material. And sometimes this is easy and sometimes it's not. Remember, if I click on a clip here, I could hit F, and that's going to match frame. And that loaded the clip. But what I really want to do is go back to the bin, because chances are the other takes are in the same bin.
In Avid or in Final Cut, well, in Avid, we call this find bin. In Final Cut, it was reveal and project, I think.
Yeah, and we got reveal and project here with the right click, but there is no keyboard shortcut. But like just about all commands, you can go ahead to your keyboard shortcuts under the Premiere Pro menu on a Mac or under the Edit menu on a PC, and I'll just type reveal. And I'll say, oh, timeline panel. Yeah, that's the clip I select in the timeline. Let's do Shift F. And that's already taken in this case, but you know what?
You know what?
I don't mind.
I don't mind. I would end up using the find manually anyway.
Yeah. So I'm because I have to click on it anyways to start typing. So that's fine. I hit that and I say Shift F and it loads it back.
And what's beautiful is it doesn't make a difference how buried it is in your project. It's just going to roll open whatever it has to get to that shot.
Yeah. And I'll just open that up there and take a look. And I see that I've got some different takes. And so I used 8587. Well, I'm going to guess that 8588 was the very next take.
Probably a good guess.
So we'll load that up. And in this case, I've already flipped over. But you'll see here.
You flipped what over?
To the waveform view.
There you go.
But you can always change that by just clicking settings and taking a look at the composite video or anything else. And if we listen to this dialogue here, I'm just going to take the audio up so you hear the performance.
Hey, Joan, I'm Skip, and I'll be your doctor today.
It's a little flat, and he started talking before he hit his mark. He was off camera when he said his line. Well, I can easily put the new take in. So let's just make this so we can clearly see our audio waveforms.
Hey.
And I'm going to go with the word hey. There's the first word.
Because what we're going to end up doing here is we're going to end up replacing this with the other take.
Yeah. So I can load that clip. And there I start to say the word hey.
Perfect.
And so I have the playhead in both positions to determine where the edit should line up. So in order to use the replace, you want to make sure you select the clip and have the timeline panel active, and then you could choose clip, replace with clip.
Now there are three choices here. From the source monitor, it's just going to take an endpoint if there is one, and if not, it'll take the head of the clip. From the bin, I use all the time. I'm often finding myself with a piece of B-roll I want to replace with a different one, and I usually am very fastidious. I actually mark an endpoint, never at the head of a shot, on a lot of my B-roll shots, knowing I may come to want to replace them. But in this case, we want
the source monitor match frame. And because I've put the playhead on the critical action in both cases, when I choose this, look very closely at what happens in the timeline. Even though we have a transition applied and we don't have, you know, we have an L cut and a J cut here, when I do that, it swaps it out. And so the transition stayed applied, it preserved the edit points.
Hey Joan, I'm Skip, and I'll be your doctor today.
It's a better read, and what's beautiful here is that it kept everything. It's just, it's one of the more sophisticated implementations of replace edit I've seen in any NLE. And the beauty of it, again, is you have three different ways you can do it.
Yeah, and so it's up to you. If you just want to work out of your bin or you want to work out of the source monitor, remember, if you got a bunch of clips loaded, you can quickly pick through. But I think for things like swapping out one line read for another, that option that allows you to actually match it based on the playhead goes a long way.
Huge. And then, as I said before, you definitely should be taking a look at just replacing from bin. It's a quick way, especially with the new hover scrub feature, to have a bin of shots open and just try different shots with your client. But again, that's something you probably ought to map to the keyboard.